Hello students, welcome to your education online class. We are at the fifth part of the video and in the last day we have discussed the responsibility of a family, the biological responsibility of the family. Today we are going to start the educational responsibility of a family. Now see, before I start, I must say that education, we all know it is highly important, isn't it? Education is the ultimate identity of individual. What you have learned, how you have learned, what is your behavior, what is your way of talking, what habit you have, is it good or bad, everything includes, means everything starts from family, isn't it? Because first bringing up of suppose 2 years or 2.5 years, how much the child will stay in home is very precious, because the child used to learn, they used to observe. As informal institute of education, I have told you that home or family takes a very big responsibility, and they used to say that yes, this habit, this is very good habit, but is formed from the parents. This is very bad. Your parents should teach you this. So everything, when a baby or a child used to do anything, we used to say that maybe family is responsible, or the learning of the family or the teaching of the family is responsible. So family, being an informal institute of education, is highly important for all the individual, because right from the 0 day up to a certain age of the child will remain in family. Thus, we have discussed the biological need of the biological responsibility of the family. Today, we are going to start with the educational responsibility. Number one, responsibility of behavior. See, just now I was telling, suppose we see that sometimes someone is very rude. We used to say that what type of education the child has got. He don't know how to behave with elders. He don't know how to behave with others. Or maybe we appreciate sometimes that is how good behavior has got, way of talking, way of looking, everything depends on the family. So the responsibility of behavior is here, what type of behavior is child showing, that is very important. Next is responsibility of habit formation. Now see, plenty of good habits and plenty of bad habits are there. Brushing of teeth, bathing properly, keeping yourself neat and clean, keeping your dryer, your bookshelf neat and clean without any dust and dirt is a sign of good habit. Now, right, some thoughts are there that yes, maybe it is good, it is irrespective to individual, how individual think, but some good habits we, every individual, should form, and that we receive from our parents. Like brushing your teeth at the time of morning and before going to your bed is very important. So that is a part of habit formation. We see our parents that they are following, we used to follow the same. So habit formation, good habit formation is a very big responsibility of family. Third point, responsibility of vocational education. See, sometimes we see that the father and the mother is teacher, the child is also a teacher. The father is a doctor and the mother is a doctor. So the child is also a doctor. So the responsibility of the family is to convince the child that what their parents are doing is good for you also. Though it is not compulsory to take whatever they have taken, whatever they have chosen, it is individualistic. But still, it can be provided by the parents that yes, what vocation we have got, the same vocation you can take the guidance. Maybe it can be guided by the parents. Next point, responsibility of emotional development. Now, it is highly important. Emotional balance is a very important balance. You cannot do, emotion is a great controller, isn't it? It will reflect on our personality as well. So if you cry suddenly, if you smile suddenly, if you get angry suddenly, then there will be an imbalance of your emotional development. So family will always teach the students that how to react, where to react, how to not, and how to do it. So emotional responsibility is a very big responsibility of individual. mental development means what? Mental development means how, what is good, what is bad, what is your mentality toward a particular incident. So when something will happen, if the child will think something else, the parent's duty is to set up the mentality of the child that see, you should not think it like that, you should think like this. Isn't it? So the mentality and the mind and the way of thinking will be changed in individual. Next is the responsibility of social development. See, being a part of the society, we have to pay some rules and regulations. We are bounded by some rules and regulations. So suppose a child is very young and he is having temper tantrum, and the parents used to say, today we are going to a party, so over there many people will be there, don't react differently, they will say you bad boy or bad girl. This we are habituated to listen, isn't it? And we used to guide that eta corona, ota corona, eta korbe na, don't do this, don't do that. It is very good, you can say it like that, and it is bad too. If you behave, everyone will say bad to you. So this social development means group living, group culture, group thinking, thought of cooperation, everything will be taught by the parents to the child. Finally, responsibility of spiritual consciousness. Now, what is included in spiritual development? Spiritual consciousness means when someone is telling, yes, it is good or it is bad, it is correct, it is incorrect, morally it is well, it is not well, do's and don'ts of life. That also we learn majority from our parents, because we majority things which we experience is okay. But whatever our parents used to tell us, we used to think that yes, it is good what they are teaching us. So the morality, the goodness, the badness, the okay and do's and don'ts, everything we have learned from our parents. So these are more or less the responsibility of a family. Behavioral responsibility, habit formation, vocational guidance, emotional guidance, mental development of mental health, you can say, social development, and finally spiritual consciousness, where the child will be conscious about the society and react accordingly. So this is all about today's video. Next day, in the next part, we are going to discuss the disquality of the family, or the disadvantages of the family. Thank you very much.